This is just an example for you to understand how we can solve these stoichiometry problems. They're all very similar. They follow the same pattern. So I'm going to show you three ways to do this. The first way is pretty easy. What we need to do, we have 3.2 grams of oxygen. And what we're trying to find out is how many grams of water we end up with. So we'll just put grams of H2O here. So first, let's balance the equation. We have one oxygen here and two here. Put a two here. Two times two is four. So put a two here. That gives us four. That's balanced. Always have to balance the equation for stoichiometry. And let's call this one here. It's not written, but that's the coefficient. Because these coefficients, 2, 1, 2, that gives us the mole ratio. All right. So our goal is to take grams, change that to moles of O2, use the ratio from the coefficients to get moles of H2O, which we then just convert back to grams. And we're done. So the quickest way to do this is look, for every one mole of O2, I have two moles of H2O. That's the ratio. So if I have 0.1, I'm just doubling this number. So all I really need to do is double this. Now I have 0.2 moles of H2O, and I can just convert that to grams. That works out to be 3.6 grams of H2O, and I'm done. So I can visually inspect this, look at that ratio. I see the moles double. So I double my moles here, change it back to grams. That's probably the quickest way to do that. And it works for most stoichiometry problems. Let's take a look at another way real quick. So we already figured out that we have 0.1 moles of O2. We just converted the grams given in the problem. So we could say that we have 0.1 moles of O2, and we don't know how many moles of H2O we're going to get, because that's what we're looking for here. Then we can convert it to grams. This is just a ratio, so I could cross multiply and solve for x. So 1 times x, that's x. 0.1 times 2 is, that's 0.2. That's the moles of water here. And we're done. We would take the moles, change it to grams, and we get 3.6 grams, just like we did before. So we have our 0.2 here that we figured out by setting up the ratio with these coefficients. Again, now we use the coefficients here as a mole ratio, but we don't mess around in here as much. It's a good way to do it. Probably though, your teacher wants you to do it this way, and they may have taught it to you this way. You get the same answer, you're using the ratios, just it's a little more general. You could apply it to some other stoichiometry problems. So let me show you that way too. So here we have our 0.1 moles of O2 that we figured out, and now we'll use the mole ratio. So what we could say is for every one mole of O2, we have two moles of water. That's the ratio. And down here, we could also say for every two moles of water, we have one mole of O2. That's valid as well. So we're going to multiply by one of these ratios. We want to end up with moles of water. So if I multiply 0.1 moles of O2, let's move it up some, times this ratio here, I'd have moles of oxygen here and here, so I'd multiply them. I get moles of oxygen squared. That doesn't work. So we can't use this ratio here the way we wrote it. But let's use this one down here. Now, when we multiply, we have moles on the top and the bottom. They cancel out. 0.1 times 2, that's our 0.2. And then we just converted that back to 3.6 grams. We multiplied times the molar mass of H2O to get that. And we get the same answer we got before. The only difference is the way we used our mole ratio. This is nice because we see the units canceling out. We're left with the units we desire. And that does help make sure you've done this correctly. So those are three ways you solve your typical stoichiometry problem. And it's always going to be the same thing. You'll be given something, convert to moles, use the ratio to get moles of the desired quantity, and then change it back to whatever you need. That's it. It's Dr. B. We're looking at how many grams of H2O will be formed if you start with 3.2 grams of oxygen, and that's an example of a typical stoichiometry problem. Thanks for watching.